following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Kevin in Orlando. Hey, Kevin, what's going on?
Hey, I'm doing great. You know, I am addicted to TFNN.
We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here. It's a great network, man. And I want to thank everyone out there, you know, for making it a great network.
Well, it's great because I do outside sales, so I get to have the station on my phone the whole day. And when I go pick up the kids at from school at 3 o'clock, they all love and give the old ram. Educating the kids at a young age is a good thing.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. So make it a great night, folks. Don't make assumptions. Let your life be transformed. When you stop making assumptions, your word becomes impeccable and your life is completely transformed. Magic just happens when... in your life, when you, magic happens in your life, what you need comes to you easily because the spirit moves freely through you. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 314, NASDAQ up 106, S&P's up 40, gold contract down $22.60, traded at $1,281 an ounce. Silver down 16 cents, $18.21 an ounce. Platinum up a buck at $9.98 an ounce. Copper up 4 pennies at $2.31 a pound. Light sweet crude up 79 cents, trading at $44.84 a barrel. Bonds, the 10-year note, down 12 ticks, 129.27. 30-year bond off 24 ticks, 162.19. King dollar up 677 ticks, trading at 97.65. The euro is at a buck 10, and the yen is at 104.52. iPhone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. We'll know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Okay. So, you're up $3.89. SPY's trading to 212.44. And what I expect you're going to see here, folks, is that this thing's going to try to get up into the 215.32 level. That was the swing high that was out here on the 24th. What you're going to see there also is this. Now, we're going up. This looks like a B to a C of an ABC structure down. You're going up one light of volume. You've come down with volume. We're coming back into the downdraft that was created out here on the 9th of September as well as the 11th of October. So I expect you're going to get follow through here tomorrow. Another gap. And I suspect that gap, depending if you're a bull or a bear, the bears will be selling that gap. I'll be selling that gap. The Qs, NDX 100, same type of setup. The Qs are up $2.43. They're at $116.08 right now. The Qs, I suspect, can get up into about the 117.67 level. Yeah, it can get up to that level. So we'll see how that shakes out tomorrow. Now, the Dow Industrial is a different ballgame. This is kind of intriguing, like what's going on with the Dow. And I think the Dow is going to give us the better clue as to when to sell this market. So, and it's a different setup. The Dow is up 309 points. We're at 18,198. Now, it looks to me like the Dow can actually make a run to 18,404. So that's another couple hundred bucks where we are. What that level is, that is the level that the Dow is trying to get over since its downdraft of September 9th. That's the September 9th number. Now, we had gone up and tested that on the 23rd of September, as well as the 10th of October. My take is that that's where we're going to get up into that level. Gold contract, what do we have with gold? Gold's down 22 bucks. You've done 201,000 contracts. Now, that's high volume in the context of what we've done here today. It's not high volume, however, as to what we're going into. We're going into 233,000 contracts. So the pullback is decent. And I expect, it looks to me like you're more than likely building a B to a C of an ABC structure on the way up. And the contract as well as the equities. We take a look at the silver contract. Silver is set up the same way. What we have with silver is this. Silver has already rejected lower price. Silver got down to $18 today. You're trading 1821. It has volume of 57,000, while you're going into 92,000. So silver is also a nice setup. In both cases, it looks to me like they're setting up to get up and over the downdraft of October 4th. Bonds, we go take a look at the 10-year note first. And notes and bonds are also giving us the heads up, folks, that this market wants to go south. And what it is that notes are down 12 ticks today. That's not only, you know, price-wise, it's not that bad, but the amount of volume is so anemic, it's amazing. So you're down 12 ticks. We're at 129.28. You've done 708,000 contracts. Well, we're coming into 1.4 million contracts. So the notes are still saying they want higher price. We go over to the bond market. We take a look at the 30-year bond. And we have with the bond, that also is down 21 ticks. It only has 150,000 contracts, and you're going into 315,000. So in both cases there, they also look that they want higher price, lower yield. King dollar. We go over to King dollar. What do we have with King dollar? King dollar right now is trading up 682 ticks. We have done 18,000 contracts. Put this back up. There we go. That also looks like it's doing an ABC structure on the way down, and it's doing the B to C of an ABC structure down. What we've done is this. When we came down with the 25,000 contracts, 27,000 contracts. Now you're going up into that level with 18,000. Good old King Dollar, I suspect, can get up into the 98,225 mark. So that would be 500 more ticks than where we are. And what I do expect we're going to see, you know, right across all the boards out here, is that you're going to see a market that continues, that stays at the highs and continues to actually get into higher price tomorrow, setting up that C point of the ABC structure, that the potential ABC structure on the way down. We get into the small caps. We take a look at the Russell 2000. Russell 2000 also looks to be setting up a B to C of an ABC structure on the way down. If we use the IWM, what you're going to see is that the IWM, the first leg down, this is a really big A to B leg, actually, on the IWM. On a weekly, you could actually say it's 125.82 down to 115. So it's a decent one. You're bouncing today with the IWM with 21 million shares. Well, the 21 million is going into 34 million, going into 35 million. And this little baby can bounce up into 118.17 right now. That can get up to 120.11. So what I do expect you're going to see here is that you're going to see more buying. You're going to see buying follow through. We'll see how this shakes out tonight. Right now, you talk about anemic volume. It has the price going, but the volume is anemic. We've done $535 million on the NYSE thus far, and we have done, let's see, $1.3 billion on the NASDAQ. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials up 315. NASDAQ's up 106. S&Ps are up 40. We're going to be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, 2x currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now up at 324. We get the NASDAQ up 109. S&P's up 41. As we do each and every Monday at 20 past the first hour, we have our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes. Now, don't forget, folks, at TFNN, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, we start live programming 8 o'clock in the morning, go to 5 in the afternoon. Tuesday, Thursday, 7 o'clock in the morning to 6 in the afternoon. Steve's got an outstanding show on every trading day, 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time. You can get all that programming right on your cell phone. You go to TFNN.com, hit Tiger TV. You're going to get some great HD quality video as well as audio. Now, as you come over to our website at TFNN, you can test drive Steve's newsletter. The way you do it, go to newsletters, go to trading newsletters. You'll see Mastering Probability. You can test drive that 30 days absolutely free. Steve Rhodes, what's going on?
Well, we could say A, B, C, D. We can say Gartley buy patterns. We can say that either the market knows something and we've just seen a nice bottoming pattern, or it could be the Michael Jordan head fake. So, and I'm not sure which one it is. I know the patterns that are out there. If you and I were writing a book right now, and we were going to try to teach listeners, subscribers, readers about Gartley, or just reversal patterns,
yep,
they're all over the place with inside the S&P 500. So that's what I'd like to start with, just so that,
okay,
and this is going to be the interesting thing. You know, does the market really know something ahead of time, not with regard to who's going to win, but how it's going to react regardless? And that's really what I see in today's action. So the first place that I'll start with regard to the S&P 500 is just simply the completion of the A to B equals CD down pattern. This is something that I teach in my workshops and is included in the newsletter service, Mastering Probability. And today was the day where we have that reversal candle. And for me, when I take a look at these A to B equals CD patterns, only 60% of the time is that C to D leg going to be the one-to-one. And the question is always, or the question that I identified how to determine whether it's going to be more than a one-to-one, is we just wait for the market to communicate to us. And in this case here, we see some type of bullish reversal signal, which is what we have. We have a three-day candle session out here inside the S&P 500. This is a Morningstar pattern, and we've got a nice little 1 to 1.272. So here's an example. We're on the one-to-one basis on the way down. The S&P 500 exceeded that price objective, which was 2105. Went to the next level on Friday, got down, really on Thursday and Friday, got down into the 2085 level. Now, what that formed is a nice Gertley buy, a nice confirmed Gertley buy pattern, which only requires you to be, in this case here, a nice leg off of that June. What's interesting here is what I'm going to say next is that where the bottom, the last bottom came in was that Brexit. Yes. Vote out here. And I don't know that really, you know, who wins the election, that we're going to see the same type of Brexit, you know, limit down type of scenario. At this stage, the one thing that we do have going for us is we've got a nice bullish reversal pattern. Now, Gertley buy patterns, Tom, they've got five different outcomes. And those five different outcomes look like this. The first outcome is a 0.382 retracement. And we can see that right now we're actually trading on that level. We're trading at 21.25 in the cash S&P. Well, we're trading at 21.26. The 0.382 retracement level, which is level number one, is 21.25. But what we've done is, or what the market has done, the S&P has done, is come into that level with a wide-ranging bar. Markets do not end, or typically do not end, on a wide-ranging bar. So I know that you're looking for more of a bounce to set up maybe an A to B equals CD to the downside. And I would say that this chart here is confirming what it is that you're looking for. Now, the next level would take us up into the 0.618 retracement area, about 21.51. Are you targeting the September downdraft? Are you taking a look at the top of that, which would be level number three, 21.69 in the S&P?
Well, let's see. You want the cash or the future?
Yeah, let's just look at the cash.
So on the cash, you're at 21.25. At the cash, I'd be saying that, yeah, you could probably go to, 21.46.
21.46. Okay, so yeah. 21.51, 21.46, that's going to be your 618 retracement inside of the S&P. Now, interestingly enough, right around your 21.46. So what's great about the level that you just identified is that we can also see that there's a nice descending price channel that has really contained price. In this case here, it's a diagonal price channel from upper left to lower right. So the 21.46 area that Tom is taking a look at, it's really right in that zone. So, you know, if price holds there and it reverses down, says we couldn't bust that descending price channel up, you go back and you revisit the lows here. Likewise, if we break through that, that says we're going to go hit 21.51, maybe 21.69. Maybe this was the significant, what we'll call Santa Claus rally bottom out here. And then what's interesting about the S&P 500, I move on to this chart here, is that today, if we take a look at the one-day rate of change in the volatility index, the spot volatility index, right now we're trading at minus 16.88. What that means is we're down over 16% from the close of Friday. Now, this chart here, and what's referenced on this chart are the green arrows that folks would want to take a look at, is those show other instances where the volatility index has had greater than a minus 10% move. And typically, what you will see at least another day's move to the upside. So that's just a confirming piece of information that that price area that you're looking at is more likely to happen. We have seen a failure in the last year, and that failure took place on June 24th. But normally these can be initiation moves, as we've seen here coming off of the Brexit low, well, the February lows, I should say, and really the Brexit low. The same type of day out here was an initiation move to higher prices. So if that descending price channel gets broken through, if your 21.46 area gets taken out, that's saying that today we have another checkbox that says this could be an initiation move all the way back to that either the downdraft from September the 9th, or maybe all the way back up to new highs out there. So that's what the VIX index is communicating to you and I. My clients and I, because of other messages that the VIX index was providing to us when we took a look at all of the futures contracts that went out to July of 2014, we went long the S&P 500 on Thursday. So we've caught a piece of this. And I'll kind of gauge what to do tomorrow, depending on these levels that you and I are really taking a look at, that 21.46, 21.50 level out here. And with regard to the VIX index, as long as it trades right now below 1972, and it's trading right now at 1876.
Okay.
We should see the market continue to move sideways to higher out there. If for any reason, folks, if we wake up tomorrow morning, the cash VIX index is trading above 1972, 1973, it's going to be a downer. It's going to be Debbie Downer. It's going to be a down day, as long as it closes above that. More likely than not, we're going to see a VIX index move to about the 1736 area, which is going to put enough energy for the markets to move higher. So a very interesting day. If we were to go through each of the sectors inside the S&P 500, we'd see butterfly buys. We'd see Gartley buys. We'd see my price relative strength divergent pattern. So lots of reversals. Either going to be the great Michael Jordan head fake, or we've just seen the next Santa Claus rally bottom. And I'll just say, ho, ho, ho.
It's pretty amazing, I know. December. I mean, November. We're going into December. Unreal.
Tom, the market typically makes a bottom in that October, November time frame, and that's the part of the rally that folks want to be able to. So let's get this election stuff behind us and let the market guide us to the next step out here.
Come over to our website at TFNN, go into newsletters, trading newsletters, mastering probability. Steve, thanks so much, man. Look forward to the show tomorrow.
Take care.
Stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 324. You get the NASDAQ up 107. S&Ps are up $40. Percentage-wise, this is what you have. You have the Dow up 1.8%. NASDAQ up 2.1 and the S&P's up 1.9. Let's go to Paul in San Jose. Hey, Paul, what's going on?
Hey, Tom, how you doing, buddy?
Doing great, man. Yourself?
Hey, I'm doing awesome, man. Thank you for asking. And Getting ready for this election. You getting your popcorn ready?
I'm getting my popcorn ready, man. No doubt.
It's going to be wild, I'll tell you that.
There's no doubt. You can see what it does to the markets, like up, down, all around about 2 seconds.
It's insane. So I wanted to ask you about MUX. I was getting really nervous this morning when I seen, you know, the gold futures, but it came back pretty good. I have an entry at 310. I was looking for it to get up maybe close to this $4 level. Just want to know what you think about this right now.
Let's take a look. So you got McEwen Mining, folks. This is a gold and silver producer in the Americas. So the low in this is 79 cents for the year. The high is $4.92. And as you just said, I mean, this held up really well today. What I don't see with this, Paul, is, now it held up well, but it hasn't really had some really good signs of strength. You know, last Wednesday, as the other equities had strength, this did too, but not really heavy. So I'd be careful with this, man. Let me just see when they're coming out with numbers. So they already came out with numbers. Either that, or they might even do them just every, it's the third of, see, they might do them once every, he might only come out once every 6 months. I'm not sure. But his next number is March 13th of 2017. So it's just, this equity is just not as strong as the other gold equities. You know, so be careful, man. Do you know what I mean? It's, you know, you're getting a huge amount of flack at this 373 level. You know, you can see and where that flack came from. So we went to the 373 level, folks, October 20th. Well, you know, you got there, which is decent, okay, but you can see it was 2.4 million and you're going into 6.9 million. You know, so there's some real selling there, man.
So. Yeah, the volume was making me really nervous. And then this morning, like I said, and then it came back. It looked really good today. I thought about taking this off the table Friday. I was really close to doing that Friday because I have a nice gain in it. I mean, I got in at 310. It's been a nice move. I have some nice profit in it.
Do you own any other gold stocks?
Right now, no. Just MUX.
What if you look at gold stocks? I would take that money off the table and put it in another gold stock that you think is stronger, because there's a few that are much stronger than that. And because of the pullback today, these setups are really nice in the gold market today. I mean, these pullbacks are nice, man. They're pulling back. They have lighter volume, all of the above, you know. So there's some good setups out there, man.
Awesome, Tom. Thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it, man.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one.
You too.
Let's go to our man, Jim in Minneapolis. Hey, Jim, what's going on, brother?
Hey, Tom. Just getting ready for the fireworks tomorrow with everybody else, like you said.
Yeah, totally.
After licking our wounds from the Motor City Kitties over the weekend and getting beat by Detroit, we're going the wrong way after the bye week.
Sorry, man. Yep.
But
your heckler mine is going the right way, isn't it?
Yeah, there's some volume in this thing today too. It looks like
this is, you know, heckler mining, folks. This is a really strong silver stock, really strong too, because you get
a report tomorrow morning.
Yeah, let's take a look. It's I believe it is. 1 second. Get this thing up. There we go. Okay, so, before the market tomorrow morning.
Yep.
And, you know, for gold being down, the thing that's amazing, folks, is that, you know, you have gold down pretty good. But the contract itself, as I said at the beginning of the show, is coming back into strength with a lot lighter volume. You know, Heckler's taken out its swing point right now with volume. So, you know, Heckler's saying, hey, guess what? This thing can go to 703, man. 703 to the 726. This is impressive.
Yeah. Okay.
It's impressive.
If you get through that high, the 726, where would you
Let's take a look. So, oh, this would be cool. Wow. Okay. So this is quite a run here. So when you look at this equity, folks, in January is at $1.45. You get up to 726. Wow. Let me put this on a monthly. Well, first I put it up 5 years. Oh, look at that. Okay. Well, this is going to, you know what's cool about this too, folks, is that this is going to tell us a lot about the silver and gold market in general. Well, you know, if you launch that area, man, then you got 1140 on the agenda.
Gotcha.
And that's what it looks like anyway, because what you've done, let me just see this for a second. So if I put this way. Yeah, you know, see, when it actually broke topside, you know, in January, it's saying it wants to go there anyway. Yeah, I mean, you're outside. 1152 is game here, man. It's pretty intense.
Yeah, I had orders in it. I mean, it didn't pull back as far as I thought it would. I had, you know, orders underneath the market to buy it, but it never pulled back far enough.
You mean this morning, right? Is that
yeah.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, exactly. So, all right, Cook and Tom, well, we'll see what happens tomorrow and get the popcorn ready and we'll take it by storm.
Totally. It's a beautiful thing.
All right.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Let's go to Mike in Colorado. Hey, Mike, what's going on?
Hi, Tom. Greetings from your northern Colorado old stomping grounds.
It's a beautiful thing, brother. Thank you.
We're sweating. It's like 70 all month up here. We're roasting and toasting.
Really?
Wow. Yeah, it's cooking. Cooking, brother.
Cooking, brother. I like it, man.
I'm looking at Realty Income Corporation, which stock symbol is O. It's coming in to 1.8 million and 2 million shares with only 1.1 million shares today. And I wanted you to tell me what you think. It looks like it's going to be stuck. It won't go any higher, in my opinion.
Let's take a look at it. So the symbol is O. They own and manage commercial properties across the United States. So the low for the year is 45. The high is 72. It pays a 4% dividend. Excuse me, folks. Okay, so you've come down off of 72, you're at 58. Oh, I see what it's doing. Okay. So you're going into, I have this on a weekly now, Mike. So you're going into that breakout area from February. 54 is the low. It hit 56 with 10 million shares versus 19 million. Well, I mean, this thing looks like it can go to $60. You know, and because of the way this downdraft was, you know, that'll stop it, I think, in the first time up. But it looks like it wants to do that.
Yeah, last week there was 2 million shares on a down day, and we just hit it today, and then we backed off. It didn't like going into that price range from last week.
No, I got it up on a daily now. I see what you're talking about, right? The 58.86. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, this will try to get in there, though. It's just because it's been down so long. Do you know what I'm saying? You know?
Yep.
Now, are you long or short this?
I had someone I work with who was long, and we closed out the position to until after the election. So we're not in it anymore.
Okay.
I didn't like what it was going into.
Yeah. Have a great one, man. Have a safe one.
Thank you.
Thanks.
You too. Bye.
Stay right there, folks. We're coming right back. Dow right now is up 318. NASDAQ's up 107. S&Ps are up 40. We're going to be right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured.
These four-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 326. You get the NASDAQ up $1.10. S&Ps are up 41. If we take a look inside the Dow Industrials, strength versus weakness, guess what? Every Dow stock is up, folks. J.P. Morgan's the leader out here, up 3%. Intel's number two at 3%. Goldman Sachs is up 3%. GE's up 2.8%. The laggard is still up 0.3%. That's Travelers Insurance. Verizon's up 0.4%. Walmart is up 0.5%. Inside the NDX 100, what do we have? Inside the NDX 100, you have Regeneron is up 6.5%. Biogen is up 6.4%, NTAP, Net Appliance is up 5%, and NVIDIA is up 5%. Taken away from it, Alexa Pharmaceutical is down 6.5%, Liberty Ventures is down 1.5%, Activision is off 1.5%, and O'Reilly Automotive is down 0.7%. If we take a look at how the volume is going to come in here, what we have is thus far is this. On the NYSE, you've done... So we get 18 minutes left in the market. You're at 591 million. Okay, so I expect that's going to push in about 750, 800 million. That has the qualifications, volume-wise, for the B2C of an ABC structure on the way down. We came down on the NYSE, folks. You were coming down on a billion, and you were coming down on 900 million. On the NASDAQ composite, we all have 1.5 billion shares. That will come in about 1.75. That also has the volume characteristics for an ABC structure on the way down, meaning that we have come down on volume. You're bouncing with lighter volume. We'll see where this shakes out. This is going to be a nice setup. And there's many setups, when Steve was on saying, across the market. And what's really cool about that is that you can glean much more out of the marketplace when you have this many setups. Corresponding, whether you're talking, well, if we go over to the dollar index for a second. So if we look at the dollar, you know, the dollar has a nice move out here, but guess what? This move is a B2C also of an ABC down, well, potential ABC down. It's up on 19,000 contracts. You're going into 25,000 contracts. You're trading 97.75, and I expect that, guess what? 98.225 is game, and that is another 500 ticks from where we are, meaning on the way up. I particularly like how the notes and bonds are trading. Notes and bonds both have backed down with dramatically lighter volume. The bonds, the notes have backed down with 721 million shares, contracts rather, versus 1.5 million contracts. That's pretty intense. If we go over and take a look at some of the higher volume stocks, even though we don't have high volume out here, these would be the leaders. You have Bank of America up 43 cents. We have GE up 87 cents. You get Apple up a buck and a quarter. Microsoft up a buck 65. Let's go take a look at Microsoft. Microsoft got some movement behind it. So Microsoft, Yeah, see, Microsoft's already at highs, too. Put this back on a weekly. So Microsoft, 3 weeks ago, takes out its highs. This is an ABC up. Interesting. So 48, yeah, it's 10 bucks. 65 bucks. And we've hit 61.30 thus far. So Microsoft wants a higher price. That's how this baby's shaking out right now. If we go into the XAU, the HUI, what you're going to see out here is that we'll get the volume after market. Well, it's about 8 o'clock at night on the XAU and the HUI, but I suspect it's going to be lighter volume because the stocks that trade inside the XAU and the HUI have had lighter volume. Now, if you take a look at this, it's pretty neat because last Wednesday, the XAU got to a high of $92.16. We did that with 56 million shares traded. You are pulling back, and I expect this pullback is going to be on dramatically lighter volume. And what the XAU has already done is rejected $85.34. And you haven't made the swing low. So that's positive in the aspect that you very well may be setting up a ABC structure up inside the XAU as well as the HUI. You set up this HUI, which we have with the Gold Bugs Index today, is that you're down $8.32. You're trading at $209.07. You hit a low of $205. It's rejected that level. Your swing point is down to $203.08. Guess what? Same setup. And from last Wednesday, you get that nice spike high at $226. Now, that level there, folks, was... So last Wednesday, and this is where the cause gets... When you're building cars, it takes that to get through a downdraft. Last Wednesday, we were going into, and all these equities are going into the downdraft from October 4th. So it absolutely is going to take some building of cars, some strength in order to get through that area. If you want to see one of the correlations, if you go look at Barrick Gold, which is the largest weighting inside both the XAU and the HUI, you'll see that Barrick got over the downdraft. The downdraft, the beginning of the downdraft, $17.25. It goes down to $15.39. Barrick, with volume, last week went to $18.95. We pulled back to $17.01 this morning. It rejected lower price. It had dramatically lighter volume. You're talking about coming back in with 12 million versus 26 million. So, you know, we'll see if this is a nice ABC structure on the way up, but that's the way that this baby's looking. If we go over to the second weighting structure inside the XAU and the HUI, it's Newmont Mining. And Newmont has done the same thing as Barrick. It's showing the strength. What Newmont has done, the downdraft started at $37.85. Last Wednesday, it gets up to $38.87. Has nice volume, has 8.6 million, as well as 10.7 million. You pull back to that 5.7. The 5.7 was going into 8 million and you rejected lower price. So both of those are set up that they want higher price. That's the way this thing is looking at this particular point. What I do expect we're going to see, number one, is that the market is staying at highs. I don't only expect the market to stay at highs, but I would expect what you're going to see out here is that you're going to see some follow-through tomorrow. And then who knows which way the wind's going to blow. My take on this, no matter who comes in, folks, is that we are setting up an ABC. We are setting up the B to C of an ABC structure on the way down. Because the bottom line is that this market has been trying to get down into the 4th of June level for quite some time. What you have had, if we go over to GE, you're going to see that there's equities that are already blown those lows away. Like with GE, the Brexit day was trading at $29.17. Well, GE, guess what, ran all the way up to $33 and then blew apart and took out Brexit day going all the way back to June 15th, okay? So now what you're seeing is that you're doing a bounce out here today on GE, and you know you're at $29.30. This can trade up to like $30.11. That's just ice from the way down. That's what GE is facing at this particular point. So there's going to be quite a few sellers at that price as it tries to get into that price. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow up 351. NASDAQ up $1.20. S&Ps are up 45. We're going to be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 362. You get the NASDAQ up $1.22. S&Ps are up 46. And you're getting some expansion as we come into the close out here. So the Dow's up 2%. NASDAQ's up 2.4. S&Ps are up 1.9. If we go over to the banking sector, we take a look at the XLF. XLF is going after its highs. You're up 48 cents. The high of the last 6 months right now is $20. We're at $19.97. And it hit $19.98 today. So what I expect you're going to see is that this XLF is going to go after those highs tomorrow. The XLE, energy, a little bit different. We have with the XLE, XLE is still in a consolidation. You know, it broke topside out of that consolidation first on the 8th of September. And then on the 10th of October, in both cases, it failed. And it got to the $71, $72 mark, gave it up, came back down to 66 twice, 67 last week. Now you're going higher. You're doing with lighter volume. So bottom line, I don't expect you're going to see the XLE make it as high as that 72 level on this time up. If we actually go over to the crude oil market, what you're going to see is this. Crude oil is trading at $45.50. That we've done 206,000 contracts out here, which is weak volume compared to how we're coming down at 278. Oil can bounce into like the 46.77 mark. You know, oil took a one-way slide the last 2 weeks. We just went from $52.68 down into this $44 area. So it looks to me like that baby wants to bounce, and that's about it. If we go over to the natural gas area, of course, oil numbers are coming out Wednesday. Natural gas numbers are coming out on Thursday. Natural gas right now is trading up a buck and a half. 1.5%, that is. We're at 298. Now, this was a one-way slide also. This went from 370 down to 290. And this also looks to me like, yeah, you can get to 311, but guess what? This is a contract that wants to go to lower price. You know, so in both cases, when you take a look at that energy market, it looks to me like oil, number one, is doing dead cat bounce. Wants to go lower. Gas looks like it wants to go lower. What has happened is that oil wants to go lower. Not the unleaded gasoline is pretty strong. Is real strong actually. And this is the divergence. Unleaded gas at $1.36, and that looks like it wants to pop actually. You know, we came down. It's dramatically lighter volume today versus Friday, and it hasn't rejected price yet, the lower price, but it looks to me like the unleaded market can bounce up to 142, and right now we're at 136. So we'll see where that shakes out as to the aspect of the divergence between the actual oil market, Brent oil, barrels of oil going south, and the gasoline market going north. If we take a look at the looks like the volume is going to come in lighter out here today. We're at 659 million in the NYSE, so that's going to be lighter volume in a big way. We on the Nasdaq Composite, you're 1.688. So the composite is going to get a little tricky because the composite can do a couple hundred million coming into the close. So 7, 8, yeah, even that it's still short volume. If we take a look at the SPY. What you're going to see, the SPY has done 91 million. You're going into 140, I believe. Let's see. You're going into 132. The Qs, the NDX 100, you've done 23 million. You're going into 23 million. I'll see. This is going to get tricky then. Well, you're going to 35 million too. Yeah, 35 million. So it's 23 into 35 in the small caps, IWM. You're doing 26 and you're going into 29. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials right now up 369. NASDAQ up $1.22. S&P's up 46. We're going to be right back.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
We got Carlos from California. Carlos, what's happening?
How you doing, Tom?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
Oh, very well. Thank you.
That's awesome,
thank
man.
Thank you very much. Can I make a comment real quick?
Absolutely.
For me, it's a real challenge every time I'm doing a trade. And thanks to your help, I've been able to done a lot of things as far as trading. And I know there's a lot of Hispanic people who are listening, and they think this is a lot hotter than it looks. But with your help, it's been a lot easier to make things sound very simple.
That's a beautiful thing, man. But well, listen, we appreciate it. We appreciate it.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Make it a great night, folks. Always do your best. Surrender and let go of the past. I love this. This is a great card. Whatever life takes away from you, let it go. When you surrender and let go of the past, you allow yourself to be fully alive in the moment. Letting go of the past means that you can enjoy the dream that is happening right here, right now. Yesterday's gone. Tomorrow's not here. What are you doing right now? Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 371. NASDAQ up 119. S&P's up 49. Gold contract down $22.90, trading at $1,281 an ounce. Silver down 17 cents at $18.20 an ounce. Platinum up $2 at $9.99 an ounce. Copper up 4 pennies at $2.31 a pound. Light sweet crude up 89 cents at $44.96 a barrel. Notes, the 10-year note down 13 ticks, 129.27. 30-year bond off 24 ticks, 162.19. Now, for a market that went up 2% across all the indices, folks, this bond market pulled back dramatically lighter volume. What is that setting up? That's setting up that bonds and notes still want higher price, lower yield. I expect what we're going to see here as we're going through this market that we're setting up a B to a C of an ABC structure on the way down. King dollar. King dollar up 682 ticks, 97.77. King dollar also moved higher. Contracting with volume, that also looks like an ABC structure on the way down. We're going to go through all of these. Euro, euro's trading at $1.10, and the yen is at 104.50. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Okay. You're trading at $213.15. We did 101 million shares, and you're going into 140 million. So you get the bounce. It's on lighter volume. What I expect we're going to see here is this, is that you're going to get follow through tomorrow. More than likely, we're going to get it into about the 215.30 level. That is the swing high of the 24th. Now, what happens when you come up to that level, folks, is this. You're coming into the downdraft that was created out here on the 10th of October, as well as the larger one on the 9th of September. Those two areas, the market had been trying to get through for, you know, over 2 months now. Haven't been able to make it. The last time they were up there, it tested it out on September 22nd. It tested it out on October 10th. But I expect that's where we're going to go. That's in your S&P. Dow Industrials. Now, the Dow is set up differently. And the difference is this. You're up 371 points today. This wide price spread, they all had wide price spread. They didn't have the volume. Dow still doesn't have the volume. We did 900 million versus a billion shares. I expect, though, what you're going to see with the Dow is that we're at 18,259. This Dow is going to try to get to 18,404. The 18,404 level is the downdraft from September 9th. And as I just said, I tested it twice before, hadn't been able to do it. I expected to see another test up at that level. Now, NDX 100, same type of setup, meaning not the same type of setup as the Dow, but as the composite, NASDAQ composite. You had the three Qs go up $2.70. You've done 25 million shares. You're going into 35 million. We're 116.35. I do expect that we can actually get to approximately 118. That's what it looks like. And where I'm going with that level is that that is the high of the October 28th. Not that it was a downdraft, but it did come down into the swing point. That's where the expansion of volume. The bottom of that level is $116.74. Now, normally what would happen, folks, is this, is that that's where, you know, if we didn't have such great price spread today, normally I would be targeting the bottom of that area for the change of direction once again. And the reason I'm not is because the Dow took off so substantially. And what I expect you're going to see is that our markets wake up in the morning, bottom line, start moving up to that level, and we'll see whether they can take it out. Gold contract. So now gold got smoked this morning, all day actually. You're down $23. You're trading at 1281. That being said, this is a nice pullback. You know, that this is going into 233,000 contracts. Hasn't rejected lower price yet. We got to 278, but also hasn't gone to a lower swing point. So I expect what you're going to see is this. If we go to the XAU and the HUI, they performed. They pulled back with lighter volume. They rejected lower price. When you go through Barrick, when you go through Newmont, when you go through many of these large weighting structures that are inside the XAU and the HUI, what you're going to see is that they had lighter volume. So what I expect we're going to see is we're going to see the XAU and the HUI also have lighter volume when we get those numbers, which we'll be getting those numbers about 7, 8 o'clock tonight. Notes. We go take a look at the note market. So what you have with notes is this. The 10-year traded down to 129.24. You did 740,000 contracts. And bottom line is that that is anemic volume because we're going into 1.47 million contracts. So that's telling me that notes still want higher price, lower yield. Bonds have been struggling to get inside their higher range. They haven't done that yet. What they did do today is we backed down with lighter volume. We did 158,000 contracts, which are going into 315,000. So that's saying that the bonds, the 30-year wants 163.30. That's a point and 10 ticks higher than we are right now. Bottom line, we'll see if it can handle that price. King dollar. What do you have with king dollar? King dollar also is doing a B2C, a potential ABC structure on the way down. What we had done is king dollar up 19,000 contracts today. You're going into 25,000. So we're trading 97,775. I expect you can get the 98,225. So that's like plus another 500 ticks in king dollar on the way higher. And what I expect you're going to see, we're going to see all of this tomorrow. And of course, tomorrow is election day. You stay tuned right here at TFNN all day, because what is going to happen, folks, every rumor that's out there is going to move this market around. You can see Comey's letter Sunday. Guess what? Futures go up $46. These events are going to move the market. You can expect more movement in this market all day tomorrow. I expect Wednesday is going to be the big day, but stay right there. We're coming right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today.
An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. If we take a look at Tesla for a second. So Tesla just come out. Let's see what they're having to say here. Tesla Motors is pulling the plug on lifetime free use of its supercharged network for vehicles ordered after January 1st as the electric car maker prepares to start selling its mass market Model 3. Vehicles after ordered, this is going to be interesting watching this thing shake out. So vehicles ordered after that date will come with credits for about 1,000 miles annually of free supercharged use, Tesla said in a blog post Monday. Beyond that, users will pay an unspecified small fee that the company said will be less than the price of filling up a comparable gasoline car. Well, it should be. That's what you're buying, right? You're just going to get wild about this, folks. Details will be released later this year. So imagine this now. This gets intriguing. You're buying a... Oh, hey, let's read a little bit more first. So the supercharged network designed to allow long road trips without range anxiety has been a perk of owning a Tesla. But Chief Executive Officer Elon Musk said at the annual shareholder meeting in May that free supercharging funds only has a cost and that the obvious thing is to decouple that cost from the Model 3. Tesla plans to start delivering the Model 3 late next year and reach total production of 500,000 of its vehicles in 2008. We're announcing a change to the economics of supercharging, one that allows us to reinvest in the network, accelerate this growth, and bring all owners, current and future, the best supercharging experience, Tesla said in today's blog post. Vehicles ordered by January 1st have to be delivered by April 1st to avoid the change. The company has 734 supercharged stations in North America, Europe, and Asia. The superchargers typically deliver 170 miles of range in 30 minutes, according to the company's website. So if we go TSLA, we go and we take a look at Tesla. Okay, so Tesla's trading 193, down from 240. Yeah, this wants to go after its high volume swing low from last February. That's 163 to 141. And what you will have, this will take a while to get down there because the short position in Tesla is 24.62%. So one out of every four shares are short. And that's... You know, that's a high shot position, folks. You know, but you can see, bottom line, I guess if you're charging the Teslas at home, it's no big deal. It's still costing you electricity. But on the road, it seems to me reading that press release there, it's like they're saying it's going to come under gasoline costs. But guess what? You know, gasoline costs, are right up there. There's no two ways about it. We go over and we take a look at the... let's go take a look at ExxonMobil. So when we talk about equities inside the oil business. So Exxon has been in this huge consolidation, and this consolidation has been going on for quite some time. It got down to a price point of $82.76 last week. Now, as it come down there, you had some real juice. So it looks to me like Exxon once again will retest $82.76. You're coming into the downdraft that had been created last July. Exxon was up $1.88 today. You're at $85.45. Yeah, that can bounce about another 60 cents. That's what it looks like. Chevron, we take a look at Chevron. Chevron is much stronger than Exxon. In fact, Chevron had a monster sign of strength a week and a half ago. 28th, it goes from 100 to 105. This is going to the top of the consolidation, which is 107.56. So if we take a look at Chevron, yeah, different ball game. Chevron can actually run to 114. So we'll see how that shakes out. Inside the banking structure, you have Citigroup caught a bid out here. Well, the whole banking sector actually caught a bid out here today. Citigroup is up $1.65. They're $49.82, and that's going to go after the high volumes. Well, it's not a high volume swing, but the volume's not bad on the 27th. All the banking structure, the banking sector, has decent volume from the 27th. And it looks like that those numbers are going to get hit. If we go over to Bank of America, we'll take a look at Bank of America. That number on Bank of America is, let's see, 1710, yeah, and we're 1701. And we're doing pretty good volume. So this tomorrow's going to be a big day. There's going to be a lot of volatility in this market, folks. And what I do expect we're going to see, that being said, I expect, so picture, we have the markets opened. Well, the futures market's opened all night. So futures are going to continue to trade. Our equity markets from 9:30 tomorrow to 4 in the afternoon, coming into that close tomorrow is going to be pretty dicey. There shouldn't be a huge amount of information out there by then, but there will be information out there, and that could push the market back and forth. What I do expect is going to happen tomorrow night, if you do trade futures, that market is going to be active, and it will get real active starting 7, 8 o'clock at night. If you haven't test drove the Nadex platform yet, great time to do it. Come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see a banner on the top of the side. You can bring up the Nadex platform, and what you can do, folks, and this is, you'll learn a lot about how these defined option contracts work, and you do it with paper money. It'd be a great learning experience to be out there either buying or selling these indices tomorrow night, because we're going to see action. And as when I started the program out here today, what my take is going with this is that somehow, just as I was looking for this B2C happening, and who knows how, you know, came out with a letter, and yeah, guess what? We have the first pop. But what I'm looking for is I'm looking for a second pop also. So I'm looking for, you know, basically higher price tomorrow coming into that area that the market itself hasn't been able to make it through. And if we take a look at the SPY, the top of that area is $217.03. Now, we went up $4 today. I don't expect the SPY to actually hit the 217. Where I'm going with the SPY is approximately 215.74, somewhere in there. Because what happens is this, is that you had the price spread out here today. You didn't have the volume behind the move. If we get the price spread tomorrow and the volume dies again, what you're going to be looking for, if you are we'll go both ways. If you're bullish, what you're looking for is you're looking for not a rejection of price. You're looking that it'll get right over the 216.70 or close at 216.70. Because if you do that, guess what? Then that would be game on Wednesday that you'd actually be going for the highs of the marketplace, which is 219.60. That would be the bullish setup. The bearish setup would be that you're coming into these levels at 215.74. You hit the level and you back off the level, and we have lighter volume. That would be a setup that, guess what? This market wants lower price, no matter who is elected president. And that's my take on it anyway. But it's gonna be a good day of a trading out here. There's no two ways about that. If you haven't test drove the gold report, folks, great time to do it. Come over to our website at TFNN. You can go under newsletters. You can go under investment newsletters. You can test drive the gold report 30 days absolutely free. If you'd like to test drive my daily market insights, you can test drive that. Just go to TFNN, go to trading newsletters. You can test drive Market Insights 2 weeks, absolutely free. You can test drive both of them. You know, on a longer term basis, that gold market is in good shape right now. You know, when you get a pullback like this, this is what you have to take advantage of. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials finished up 371, NASDAQ up 119, S&P's up 49. We're going to be right back.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
It's 2016 and TFNN has a brand new programming lineup to kick things off. Starting January 4th, Swim Lessons by Thinkorswim and TD Ameritrade will be airing 5 days a week at noon Eastern Time. Join hosts Scott Connor, Kevin Hinks, and Cindy Faber as they host their daily options program live at noon 5 days a week with no commercials for the entire hour. Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark will be moving their program, Living a Primal Lifestyle, to twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 a.m. until 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Wake up with Nico and Paige and start your day off right. The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour by Nadex will now be live Mondays and Fridays at 10 a.m. Start and end the week with the three hosts, Tom O'Brien, Tommy O'Brien, and Daryl Martin, as they break down the world of trading binary options and spreads. For all the details on the new 2016 programming lineup, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over to Priceline. Priceline closed out here at a price point of $1,480. That was up $56. Well, guess what? This is up another, up another $68 after the close. So we closed at $1,480. It's trading at $1,548. And let's see what they're saying number-wise. Okay, this is pretty intense, too, that they're taking a write-down. But here, let's go through the numbers. So the estimate, the revenue estimate was $3.62 billion. They took in $3.69 billion. Their earnings, they were looking at $29.86. They made $31.18. Now, check this out. This is what's so intense about this, is that they made these numbers, folks, right, and took a write-down of $941 million on they had bought OpenTable. Let me see what they bought it at. So, 9/18/27, I believe. 9/18/27. I think they bought a $2.4 billion or something. Let's see. Okay. $2.6 billion. Okay. So Priceline wrote down the value of its OpenTable restaurant booking service by $941 million, almost a third of the $2.6 billion that Priceline paid in cash in 2014. It's pretty intense, man. The write-down cut deep into its third quarter net income, which fell 57% to $506 million from a year earlier. Excluding the charge, and some other items. Priceline reported a profit. Okay, so this is what they did. They took the write down, but they excluded that in their share price of making $31.18 a share. So excluding the charge and some other items, Priceline reported a profit of $31.18 a share. That topped analysts' estimates of $29.86 as the stock rose in extended trading. The move is a stumble for Priceline, which has used acquisition to become the world's largest online travel company by market value. Open Table was Priceline's largest acquisition and let it push beyond traditional focus on flight, hotel, and car rental booking. The thing that's so wild about this, folks, and certainly don't go short Priceline, but you can see that when you write down $941 million, and then you claim that you're making $31.18 a share, you're not making $31.18 a share, because what happens is that they excluded that charge. So if you and I were just taking care of our household, picture this for a second, you're taking care of your household. Let's say we all have a small business. You're taking care of a small business. And we say that, okay, we'll keep this easy, that at the end of the quarter, we think that we made $1,000, okay? So we're reporting saying, hey, we made $1,000. Well, in the course of that, what would end up happening, let's say a year prior to that, we had bought another business. And let's say we bought the other business at $3,000, right? And we wrote down one third of that, meaning because on a balance sheet, it's not worth, when you're writing something down, that means it's not worth what you paid for it. So it's on your balance sheet, it's $3,000. We're saying that, hey, this ain't making any money. So we're going to write down a third of it. So we're writing down $1,000. Well, we'd be looking at it and say, hey, we didn't really make $1,000. We didn't make anything, because you're just kidding yourself, because you had to take the $1,000 off your balance sheet that you thought you made. So it's intriguing when companies, you know, and they do this all the time. I just want to walk you through the aspect of it. Now, needless to say, the market is digging it anyway. You know, you're up 15.54, and evidently the market likes that they're taking the write down. So what does get intriguing is this. Expedia, right? EXPE. So picture this. And this is going to come down the pike, too. Expedia bought HomeAway. And I got to find out what they bought that for. Okay, so here, I'm going to walk you through this. When they bought HomeAway, they paid a huge amount of money for it. And the business of HomeAway, when they bought it, is that we pay $1,200 per short-term unit to get to the top of the search when people are searching, because we have short-term units down in Clearwater. So to make a long story short, what has happened is this in the last year and a half. HomeAway was great, but what the difference is that you're paying $1,250 to be the top of the range, right? Well, about a good year ago now, Airbnb came into town. Airbnb absolutely took over HomeAway like in a heartbeat. 90% of our bookings now, 90, are with Airbnb. So wait to hear what happened like last week. This is hilarious. We get a letter from HomeAway saying that something's wrong. I said, yeah, something's wrong. Guess what? Airbnb's taking all your business. And it was that quick. So the HomeAway crowd, they sold that right on time. And what has happened now is that the HomeAway business plan has changed. So the way Airbnb works is that they get a 3% commission from if you have a house and you rent it, they get 3% as the landlord. And then the guest, I believe they get another 3% off that. HomeAway is changing the aspect. They're going to do it like Airbnb, but it looks to me that the Airbnb is not only taking them over, is just going to take them to the cleaners, and I'm not sure how HomeAway is actually going to get traction again. Because see, the HomeAway label is not a label through the whole world. You have VRVO, you have HomeAway. They have a couple other different labels, and they run under different names at different places. Where Airbnb, guess what? It's Airbnb. And we can see them when they're coming into our units, whether it's from the United States. We get a lot of foreign traffic coming in, and guess what? So if we go back to Expedia again, now this is where this is interesting. This is where it comes down to Priceline. Expedia, I suspect that they are going to have to also write off a portion of that HomeAway purchase. So we'll see it. And this, with the break coming up, I'm going to see exactly what they paid for this in between the break. Now, I do not go short Expedia either, because what's happening with Expedia, Expedia's at 126. That thing wants to go to 140, which is just wild. And they already come out with their numbers, but February 9th is their next time out. LUV. So let's go over to Southwest Airlines. Southwest Airlines is up $1.19, $41.57. This is filling a gap. Now, if you want to see something that, you know, folks think that you don't have inflation out here, Southwest pilots. Now, they've been fighting for this for 4 years, but the pilots just got a boost of 30%. It's going to be over the course of a few years, but guess what? We have inflation that's in this market right now, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow finished up 371. NASDAQ up 119. S&P's up 50. I'll be right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Tom.
Take your phone calls.
Now.
Toll free at 1-877-927-6648.
Internationally
at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. And you know, we were talking to HomeAway, so check this out. So Expedia, folks, bought HomeAway for $3.9 billion. Yeah, would it be? Now, this gets more intriguing because when I was pulling this up, let me walk you through what has also happened here. Because when they changed their MO, here, let me read you this article. This is pretty cool. HomeAway, the online vacation rental site, has riled customers with the change in practices that some say make the getaway of their renters even more expensive. At issue is a new service fee that HomeAway imposed in February, so this is last February, on renters whom booked through the company's site. The move has infiltrated property owners, some of who pay HomeAway thousands of dollars each year to list on their site. That's the listing, what I was talking about, we pay $1,200. They say HomeAway, which owns VRVO and vacation rentals, is using its market power to hit renters with excessive fees. This guy, Ivan Arnold, a Los Angeles-based investor who has five homes on VRVO.com, said he was blindsided by the fees. He is the lead plaintiff in a class action lawsuit filed against HomeAway in March, claiming fraud and breach of contract. Arnold claims that the service fee has had a devastating effect on inquiries and bookings. We already paid them to list. They shouldn't go after our renters as well. So what has happened is this, is that, as I said, the owners of the units, you don't have to pay. Well, you have to pay. You always had to pay something on HomeAway. The lowest one was like $300 for a listing. The best one was like $1,200 if you wanted to have the yours pop up first. In his case, he paid $1,848 in subscription fees. So who knew? He had a bunch of units. I don't know if he was five. He was paying the smallest one. If he had five times three is 15. Plus, so this says he paid $1,848 as a subscription fee to list one of his properties on the site for 12 months. The booking fees came in after a change of ownership last year when the travel giant Expedia bought HomeAway for $3.9 billion, a move that positioned the company to compete more aggressively with Airbnb. The new owner added the booking charge, leveled on all renters of HomeAway. The fee is 5-9% of the rental costs and could add hundreds of dollars onto the price of the vacation rentals. And some renters have balked. By April, the backlash over the fees had hit HomeAway headquarters in Austin, Texas. Tom Hale, the chief operating officer, left the company after slightly more than a year on the job. He became the public face of change, and homeowners had focused their anger on him. HomeAway vigorously defends the fees and plans to use most of the money for marketing, said a corporate communication manager for HomeAway. He added that booking on HomeAway's system is safe and secure and should give travelers peace of mind. Big deal. They should be safe and secure anyway. Its critics say HomeAway is trying to limit owner-renter interaction in order to control the entire rental process. The owner-renter interaction, folks, that's Airbnb absolutely does do that. They do not allow you to have interaction with the clients until the deal is already done through the Airbnb system. You know, okay, you can't blame him because what happens if he can get outside the system, what ends up happening is that the client doesn't pay the percentage, the owner of the unit doesn't pay the percentage, and you get a customer. What is going to happen, this is what's intriguing also, though, what is going to happen in the future, and I'm sure is already happening, is that you get a customer. If you have short-term units and you keep short-term units, if the person's happy, what will happen is that they will come, if you end up having a site, they would come right to the client, they have your phone number, versus going through a system once again, more than likely. You know, because they'll save 3-5%, you probably give them a deal, you'll save money. So bottom line, that'll happen in the future. In recent years, two basic revenue models for short-term rentals have emerged. HomeAway's rival Airbnb allows homeowners to list the property for free. In exchange, Airbnb controls the booking process, does not permit the homeowner or prospective renter to communicate outside the Airbnb until payment is made. Airbnb takes a percentage of the rental between 6 and 12% and distribute the rental proceeds to the homeowner once the tenant checks in. So HomeAway model has always been the opposite. HomeAway pays a listing fee and the service has been free to renters who contact the owner directly. Then they agree to a price and it can be made either the transaction among themselves or through HomeAway's online booking. This approach allows homeowners and renters to get to know each other before committing to rent. We like to talk to the prospective tenants before we rent. Owner of a cabin in Sonora Pass in Yosemite, we can vet them. We like to know who's going to be staying in this place. We cannot do that with Airbnb. So what does happen, if you have an Airbnb site, folks, rental that you're doing, what you can do is this. Even though they're saying that they don't allow you to interact with them, when you're doing a listing, what you want to do, like we have a full contract that the tenant still has to sign with our rules and regulations. So even though their Airbnb is saying that, number one, or this person saying that we do a full vetting, we also do a full vetting, and you can do that inside Airbnb. But what happens is that you have to just make sure that their contract is in the documents so that the client that is accepting the booking from Airbnb knows that, guess what, the contract's there, they have to read the contract, and then once that the credit card does, Airbnb gets the credit card, then we send that contract out to the client, and that client has to sign it, or they don't have a place. That's what it comes down to. So you can have the same rules, regulations for your units, meaning if, you know, you don't want a lot of people in them, you don't want animals in them, whatever your rules or regulations are. So bottom line is that you're going to see, I suspect we are going to see, which when I started this whole deal out, is that you had Expedia, Priceline right off OpenTable. I expect what you're going to see is that we're going to see Expedia writing off some part of that HomeAway buy, because they paid $3.9 billion in cash. Cash, okay? Oh, unreal. Volume-wise out here, inside the indices, what you had out here is that you did $913 million in the NYSE versus going into a billion. Inside the NASDAQ composite, what we did, $1.9 billion versus $2.1 billion. You know, so the way this is set up at this point, it's still set up that you very well have a B to a C of an ABC structure on the way down. What I expect you're going to see overseas tonight, of course, is that we're going to see higher prices. You know, you get a market that's up 2% across the board, meaning our markets today, this will go right overseas. We had the Dow up 2%, NASDAQ up 2.3, S&P's up 2.2. If we go take a look at Hong Kong, what we have in Hong Kong right now, Hong Kong's trading at the Hang Seng is 2280. You know, we're game up there for 2341. You know, I expect that's gonna be a big night over in Hong Kong. And guess what? Election day tomorrow, high volatility. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. And of course, don't forget, at TFNN, you can get all the programming right on your cell phone. Go to TFNN.com, hit Tiger TV. Coming right back, folks.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, accurate,
active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at tfnn.com.
We go over to News Corporation. So a News Corporation, of course, folks, is that is the, let's see how they break this down, because yeah, they don't have Fox News inside of this, but this is a Rupert Murdoch company that owns the Wall Street Journal also. That closed at $12.22. That's trading at $12.22, trading at the same level. So News Corporation, the Wall Street Journal, published and controlled by billionaire Robert Murdoch, reported first quarter fiscal sales that beat analyst estimates amid higher digital revenues in the news business. Revenue is $1.9 billion. The New York company said in a statement that exceeded analysts' estimates of $1.96 billion. They did $1.97 billion. Digital revenue represented 24% of sales in the news division, up from 20% a year earlier. News Corporation's shares rose 4.3% in late trading, $12.75. Yeah, so this, evidently they have inside this company is, you know, the Wall Street Journal. That's how that seems to be shaken out right now. What you're going to be looking for coming into tonight, into tomorrow, what I expect you're going to see, folks, is that we're going to see higher prices inside these indices, right, straight across these indices. Now, what's going to be intriguing, of course, is that what we will have going throughout the day, which is going to rock these markets back and forth, are poll numbers. You know, bottom line, we won't get any true numbers until after the market's closed, but what we are going to get is a slew of polling numbers as folks come out of the polls and our news organizations just start laying out some numbers out here. And so volatility, yeah, this volatility is going to be in spades right across all the indices. What I expect we're going to see is that S&P, Dow, NASDAQ, that wants higher price, building up that B2C dollar also wants higher price. It doesn't look to me like gold's going lower. Gold rejected lower price out here today, down $22. Silver is the leader. Silver was rejected the $18 level. Silver ended up closing at $18.22. And, you know, a couple of these silver stocks actually went higher, which is pretty amazing in the context of how gold came down early this morning. Because percentage-wise, gold was down 1.7%. Silver was down 1.2%. That being said, guess what? They came down with lighter volume. They were going to strength. Last Wednesday, Fed day, you had gold go higher. The way the market is still set up, too, by the way, is December 14th is the next Fed meeting. The way that, and the, let's see, WIRP, the probability that the Fed will go up on December 14th, looking at the Fed fund futures rate, is 82%. So it's a big number. The market right now is saying that the Fed will raise rates on December 14th. But guess what? December 14th, folks, is a long way away. And when you actually look at the notes are saying that the short-term rate is not going to go up. The 30-year bond, however, is saying that, yeah, guess what? This thing can go up because the 30-year bond hasn't been able to get into the higher range. You know, it dropped out of that range, still out of that range. You know, we'll see where the whole thing shakes out. But I expect it's going to try to make another run for that higher range. Why? Because if I'm right in the concept that's an ABC down, once this market turns and goes south again, the Fed will freak. you know, bottom line is that they can't handle lower markets, period. And that isn't what the Fed was supposed to be there as a central banker. But guess what? That's how this seems to be shaken out. And of course, every time this market goes down, the bond market goes up, and it goes up very quickly. If we look at the concept of where we are and rates versus the world, we're still really low. The 10 years at 1.8, we're really high, rather. We're at 1.8. France is at 0.4%. Really? Give me a break. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it. Take ownership of a fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night. Safe night. Look forward to speaking right here tomorrow morning, 7 o'clock. Wow! Go get them, folks.